Buzz's Red comes from Lucius. Hello, Lucius.
Lucius.
Simon and Ali Collective, I must seek forgiveness, as this secret has weighed heavily on my conscience for many a year. Let me take you back to 1986, the year that I was at the legal age that I could indulge in a little bit of alcohol every now and again. And there's an awful lot of alcohol in a lot of these confessions. By the way, having read most of them over the weekend, I would say, here's my tip for writing a perfect confession to add to the other ones about keep it legal and avoid laxatives. You don't have to write your entire memoir when you send it in. Okay? Just saying. Anyway, Lucia says, I was a member of a very well-known, much-loved family of drinkers.
Right. Much loved.
Really. And I would regularly partake in the odd pint or three at our regular watering hole, the Prince of Wales. And the night in question was no different. Myself and my father got there about 8:45 in the evening to meet the usual suspects. These included One-Eyed Bart, the local window cleaner. His nickname will become apparent, the reason for it will become apparent later. We all took up our regular places at the end of the bar, and the night was going swimmingly. One-Eyed Bart had this nickname, as in his youth he had unfortunately had an accident where he lost his right eye and had it replaced by a slightly wonky glass one. He used to take it out, not only to gross people out, but also to drop it into his pint when he went to the toilet to stop anyone nicking his drink. Well, you would, wouldn't you?
No, you would. Absolutely. So
true to form, this is exactly what he did at this moment in time, and he goes off to the loo. What I did then is I seized my chance and I stuck my hand in his pint, plucked out his glass eye, and swapped his glass for an empty one from the end of the bar whilst no one was looking. Just then I saw him come back from the loo, and I quickly turned my back towards the bar and pretended to have a conversation with someone. Bart stood in front of the bar, looking quizzical, looking up and down, and then he said, "Where's my pint then?" Me trying my hardest to keep a straight face, I said, "Well, a bloke did come in, he stood behind me, had one drink and left. He must have drunk yours as well." "But it had my eye in it," he said. "He's swallowed my eye."
Oh.
A line I don't think I've had.
No.
"What rotten luck," I said. He then proceeded to tell everyone in the bar that someone had stolen and then drunk his glass eye. Well, at that point, all hell broke loose, and I was then suddenly surrounded by a lynch mob asking what this mystery assailant looked like.
Oh,
well, I quickly made up the most vague description of a human being you've ever. He's got a medium height, medium build, jeans, hair.
Oh, dear.
But to be honest, they were all so drunk, I could have described Barney the dinosaur, and they would still have gone out looking for him. Well, at this point, it had gone from a simple joke to a full-scale manhunt, and I was in too deep, so I had to make my escape. So in a loud voice I said, "I'll go and check the car park," and I quickly made my way to the exit. Once I was outside, my conscience got the better of me, and I did what any honest person would do in this situation, and I hid in the outside toilet.
Of course.
But whilst I was there, I realised I had a plan. I quickly pulled my shirt out of my jeans, undid a couple of shirt buttons, ruffled up my hair, slapped my cheek a number of times to make it go red. Don't try any of this at home, by the way, kids.
No.
I then grabbed the eye out of my pocket, still gross, I know, and crashed through the bar door with the eye held aloft and shouted, "Look, I've got it," at the top of my voice. I was quickly surrounded by the entire bar, all asking where I found it. I said, I told an action-packed tale of how I chased the thief and gave him a jolly good seeing to. I told him to be on his way and to never darken this door again. I was acting like a Rozza, that's what I said. Well, the residents lapped it up so much, and they gave out a great huzzah, and for the rest of the night lavished me with much praise and as many free drinks as my liver could take. And still to this day, the story of One-Eyed Bar and his missing glass eye is told like an urban legend and passed down from father to son. However, says Lucius, at this point I throw myself at the mercy of the court, beg for forgiveness, not just for making everyone think I was a hero, or the countless number of free drinks I was given for many weeks after the event, but mainly to my Uncle Bart, One-Eyed Bart, who took it to his grave, thinking that I had saved his precious, slightly wonky and total gross glass eye. Many thanks in advance, says Lucius. So the thing is, he never thought it was the good thing to do to say to One-Eyed Bart, whilst One-Eyed Bart was still with us. But with the motivation of a smart speaker.
Yes, now.
Now you tell the story,
the
Lucius.
The tables have turned.
Exactly. The tale of a swallowed glass eye, although not, as it turned out to be, Sister Susie, the voice of moral responsibility.
Well, Lucius, you just don't mess with people's pints on the bar. It causes lots of issues.
Oh, you know about this.
Susie's from the pub, remember?
Yeah.
It does. It does, you know. I've had many an argy-bargy. If you've drunk my pint, or whose is this one? No. And also, why would you leave your eye in a pint? Just that in itself, I kind of want to forgive you.
Have you ever had someone say, you swallowed my eye?
No. I have not. But do you know what? It's terrible behaviour.
So, not forgiven?
Not forgiven.
Okay, Brother Matthew, who speak for the nation.
Obviously, I'm going to forgive, but I have to. If I had the one glass, I think I might be tempted to put it in the pint just to stop anyone drinking my pint, because you wouldn't. No one's going to drink my pint if there's an eye at the bottom of my pint.
But why would you drink it?
Well, I then take the eye out. That's how it works. Yeah, see, I then take the eye out, and it's been in the alcohol. So I think
my medical
medical background tells me that that's all fine. And you know, be able to keep an eye out for my pint. Boom, and that's why I'm going to forgive. Yes.